let us all pause for a while to pray the angel. Let us remember that we are in the most holy presence of God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary,
"She was saved by the Holy Spirit."
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Behold the handmaid of the Lord.
Be it done to me according to your word.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray.
Pour forth and teach, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we, to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and death on the cross, be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Our Lethalian Prayer.
I will continue, O my God, to do all my actions for the love of you.
Saint John Baptist de la Salle.
Pray for us.
Live Jesus in our hearts.
Forever.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Welcome to this Eucharistic celebration. Our sponsor for this Mass is the DLSU's The Libraries, and our Mass celebrant is our University Chaplain, Father Luis Lorenzo of the Legionaries of Christ. Please stand, let us begin the celebration.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You were seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. All-powerful God, we are oppressed and weighed down by the ancient yoke of sin. Grant that the birth of your only Son, so long awaited, yet always new, may deliver us and set us free. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king, he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days, Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him: the Lord our justice. Therefore, the days will come, says the Lord, when they shall no longer say, as the Lord lives, who brought the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt, but rather, as the Lord lives, who brought the descendants of the house of Israel up from the land of the north, and from all the lands to which I banished them, they shall again live on their own land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever.
Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever.
O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice and your afflicted ones with judgment.
Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever.
For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save.
Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous deeds, and blessed forever be his glorious name. May the whole earth be filled with his glory.
Justice shall flourish in his time and fullness of peace forever. Leader of the house of Israel, giver of the law to Moses on Sinai, come to rescue us with your mighty power.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
This is how the birth of Jesus Christ came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home, for it is through the Holy Spirit that this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel of the Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home. He had no relations with her until she bore a son, and he named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, magandang gabi po sa ating lahat. I'm very happy to celebrate this third Simbang Gabi with all of you as I also celebrate 3 years of priesthood. Back in 2017, they used to call me the baby priest. Today, ika nga ng iba, Father, you are now a toddler priest. So mabuti po doon, bata pa rin. Toddler, learning how to walk. And it's true. There's a difference between becoming a priest and being a priest. Today we also celebrate the birthday of Pope Francis. So I ask for your prayers for our Holy Father that the Lord may bless him and give him strength, both physical and spiritual. Today we listened again to the story of Saint Joseph, who, like a priest or like a holy father, God also called to be a father, but in an unexpected way. Isn't that the story of every vocation? God calls us unexpectedly. Even when you meet the man or woman of your dreams, it's unexpected. Or the way it develops is unexpected. But heartbroken, disillusioned, Joseph chooses to walk away. But God sends him an angel saying, "Do not be afraid, Joseph. Even if it does not seem right, even if it's unexpected, God has a plan. God is fulfilling his promises." And what does Joseph do? He holds on. "I will hold on." And why? Napaisip si Father. Why did Joseph hold on? Was it to the message? Was it to the God who was revealing himself? But it made me think that maybe it's also because of the angel. An angel who pointed Joseph to the goodness of God. Just as the angel Gabriel pointed Mary to the goodness of God. That is what angels do. My dear friends, so many unexpected things have happened this year and they continue to happen. Some easier, some harder. Even if Christmas is just around the corner and all of us are hoping for rest, ilang tulog na lang, malapit na, malapit na. Ilang tulog na lang ang Paskong masaya. I would love to sing it, pero napapaos si Father, so next time na lang, next year na lang. We hope for rest. We hope for peace. And yet tomorrow is another day. And tomorrow will bring with it its own share of surprises, both small and great. But we hear the words of the angel to Joseph tonight. It was also night for Joseph. "Do not be afraid." When the surprises come, no matter how hard, my dear friends, there will be angels around you who will point you to God's goodness, whether spiritual angels or human angels, anyone who is around who will help you hold on and not lose heart. And so, a first tip, as the surprises meet your way in these days leading up to Christmas, recognize those angels. Who are those angels? And allow them to help you hold on to the promise that is Jesus Emmanuel. But I think the reason we have this reading today is not only to remember Saint Joseph of the past, Saint Joseph of 2,000 years ago, but we have this reading today to try to imagine Saint Joseph of today, Saint Joseph of 2020, nasaan si San Jose? Ngayon, ano ang ginagawa ni San Jose? Ano ang sinasabi ni San Jose? So I tried to imagine Saint Joseph tonight in heaven with God. And maybe with God, he's trying to remember his call, like an anniversary 2,000 years ago. And what is Joseph telling God? Thank you, Lord. Totoo nga. Totoo nga. Today, back in 2017, I celebrated my first Mass. I was so nervous to wear the priestly vestments, to say the priest's prayers, and especially to consecrate the bread and wine into the body and blood of Christ. I was too amazed, incredulous, and emotional that I had to ask a priest friend, Father Danny Huang, to give the homily of my first Mass. I couldn't do it. And there's something I remembered tonight that I'd like to share with you all. He said, Luis, may God give you a Eucharistic heart, one that never stops saying thank you, no matter the trials and the challenges. A Eucharistic heart, one that never stops saying thank you, despite the unexpected circumstances, despite the surprises. Like Saint Joseph of the present, not only of the past, but the Joseph of the present who with God says, Salamat, Lord. Totoo nga. Totoo nga. Brothers and sisters, I invite you all in this third day of Simbang Gabi to ask for this Eucharistic heart, to be more thankful to the Lord even more this Christmas. Not for the things that could have been, not for the things you wish could have happened, but for the things that still are, for the people that still are, for the angels that are still around to tell all of us to hold on. You know why it's so important to say thank you? Because to say thank you means that we can recognize that Jesus himself is holding on to us. Hindi rin siya bibitaw. To say thank you means to recognize that there are still signs all around that God is with us. This is the spirit of Christmas. And what a gift we receive this evening through Saint Joseph. So in this Mass, I'd like to thank our Lord, despite the challenges of the things that still are in my life. The first, for the gift of the priesthood. Still a priest and happy to be so. Second, for the gift of the church. I have learned to love the church so much in these 3 years. The many people I have come to love and be loved by. And lastly, because we are with our Lasallian family, of course, for the gift of also 3 years of serving DLSU. Sometimes I just laugh wondering why God wanted me to live my first years of priesthood with the Lasallian family. And you know, looking back, I can only say to the Lord, Salamat. Thank you. Unexpected, certainly, but planned by Him. Allow me to end this homily with the song that was played in my first Mass 3 years ago, which I think reflects this holding on to the promise that is Jesus. Brothers and sisters, may you hold on, and God grant you a Eucharistic heart. Ikaw lamang ang pangakong mahalin, sa sumpang sa iyo magpakailan pa man. Yakapin mong bawat sandali, ang buhay kong sumpang sa iyo lamang alay, at mapapawi ang takot sa akin, pangakong walang hanggan. Amen. As we bring our prayers to our Heavenly Father, let us pray especially for fathers, that they may mirror God's love here on earth. We confidently pray, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our bishops, priests, deacons, consecrated persons, and lay leaders may, like Saint Joseph, mirror your love by their fatherly care of your people, their spiritual children, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government officials and civil leaders may be sensitive and discerning of God's plan as it unfolds in the events of our national life, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That fathers working abroad or far from home may remain faithful to their families and be filled with the consolation of Saint Joseph as they celebrate Christmas away from their loved ones, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for the personnel and staff of the libraries, that this new way of learning and doing research, they may always foster innovation and remain committed to excellent delivery of services to diverse community of learners, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are undergoing crises in their personal and family lives may have the faith and hope of Saint Joseph, who sought to see God's will in unexpected and even painful realities, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died, especially fellow Lasallians, who have gone before us, may be forgiven of their sins and rest in peace in the kingdom of God, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, fill us with your Spirit. Teach us to do your will, that we may become united as one family under your fatherhood, you who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Thank you.
pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord, let the sacrifice to be offered to your name make us acceptable to you, that we may share in the immortal life of your Son, who healed our mortal nature by his death. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles of the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mysteries of his nativity, so that he may find us watchful in prayer and exultant in his praise. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jesse, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I'm not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Act of Spiritual Communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the Most Holy Sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. In this gathering of your church, the living temple of your presence, may we find in your mercy, Lord, and so approach with fitting reverence the coming feast of our redemption. Grant this in the name of Jesus, our Lord.
Amen.
Let us now pray the Oratio Imperata for deliverance against the COVID-19. God, our Father, we come to you in our need to ask for protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers. O glorious and blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, Health of the Sick.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
San Roque.
Pray for us.
San Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
San Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us. Few announcements. We thank the libraries for sponsoring our Mass tonight. We continue to invite everyone to join us in our Simbang Gabi Masses from December 15 to 23, 6 p.m. on this page, except for tomorrow, December 18, in which the Mass will be live streamed from the Manila Cathedral at 8 p.m. Our Christmas Eve Mass will also be streamed live from the Manila Cathedral on December 24 at 8 p.m. Please stay tuned after the final song for the Christmas Carol to be performed by the De La Salle Chorale under the guidance of their artistic director, Mr. Joel Aquino. Thank you.
Salamat din po, Ms. Tessie, and to the whole LSPO team headed by Ate Gina for all the hard work behind this Mass setup. Thank you very much, and let's continue to offer beautiful Masses to the Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Bow your heads and pray for God's blessing. May the Almighty and Merciful God, by whose grace you have placed your faith in the first coming of his only begotten Son and yearn for his coming again, sanctify you by the radiance of Christ's advent and enrich you with his blessing.
Amen.
As you run the race of this present life, may he make you firm in faith, joyful in hope, and active in charity.
Amen.
So that rejoicing now with devotion at the Redeemer's coming in the flesh, you may be endowed with the rich reward of eternal life when he comes again in majesty.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon us and remain with us forever.
Amen.
May the joy of the Lord be our strength. Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God. Our Lasallian prayer, I will continue, O my God, to do all my actions for the love of you. Saint John Baptist de La Salle, pray for us. Live Jesus in our hearts forever.
Sa sayana, aking araw nating pinakamimiki. Pasko, Pasko, Pasko naman muli ang pag-ibig na hahari. Pasko, Pasko, maligayang Pasko.